Alright, today we're going to talk about squares and square roots. So first things first, let's look at some definitions. So we already know about squares, and we want to know what is a square, what is special about it. So we know that a square has four equal sides, so every single side of a square is the exact same measurement. We know this is different from a rectangle, because a square is a special kind of rectangle, because it's all its sides are equal. So remember, a rectangle looks like this. And the definition of a rectangle is that opposite sides are equal. Okay? Squares can have opposite sides equal, but squares are special because all their sides are equal. Okay, so let's look at this. Now, this is saying how many little squares are in each of these shapes. So it says squares with three units on the side. So when we say three units on the side, it's just we're counting up. So it's one, two, three. So there's three on this side and three over here. Now we know that finding the area of a rectangle or the area of a square is just area equals length times width. So that's just three times three. So we know that there's nine units in here. So we got one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. So we know that there's nine. All right? And a four, so four by four, so you know 4 times 4 is 16. If you counted that, you'd have 16. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. All right? Same thing with a 5. 5 is going to have 25, and a 6 is going to have 36. So this was 5 on each side. This was 6 on each side. All right? So it's a square with the same numbers on each side, because remember, a square has all equal sides. And the units inside are, you just count how many boxes. So if you look at this, we got numbers like 9, 16, 25. There's a special name for these, and that special name is a perfect square. So whenever you have a number with a square that has the same number on each side, the area or the number of boxes inside, that answer is a perfect square. So in this case, we're saying 9 is a perfect square, 16 is a perfect square, and 25. We also said we had a 6 by 6 one, which we said had 36 inside. So 36 is a perfect square. All right, so what we should see now is that every time we make a square, we have the number of units inside makes a perfect square. So if I start with my first one, my first square I can make is a 1 by 1. And that's only going to have one unit in there, so 1's a perfect square. My next one I can make is a 2 by 2. And if I count inside, there's 4. So far we have 1 and 4 perfect squares. My next one is going to be a 3 by 3. And that has 9 in it. So far I got 1, 4, 9 are my perfect squares. Alright, and then your next one is going to be a 4 by 4. Okay, 4 by 4, if you count all that, it would have 16. So you should see a pattern here now. So all we're doing is increasing the sides, and we're just multiplying those two numbers together. So the next one would be a 5 by 5. So 5 times 5 is 25. So 25 is a perfect square. And then a 6 by 6, so 36 is a perfect square. Next one is a 7 by 7, so 49 is a perfect square. Right, and so on. So we got 8s, we got 9s, we got 10s, 11s, 12. 13. So again, I'm just multiplying these together. So this is just 11 times 11, 12 times 12, 13 times 13, and so on. So we're going to count all, we're going to keep doing this all the way until we get up to my perfect square, which is up to 400. So we'll go 14 times 14, it's going to give me 196. 15 times 15, 225. 16 times 16, 256. 17 times 17, 289. 18 times 18, 324. 19 times 19 is 361. And 20 times 20 is 400. So our perfect squares from 0 to 400 are 1, 4, 9, 16, 25, 36, 49, 64, 81, 100, 121, 144, 169, 196, 225, 256, 289, 324, 361, and 400. So remember, all we did here was we just counted, or we multiplied, and we squared the number. So this was 1 squared, 2 squared, 3 squared, 4 squared, 5 squared, 6 squared, 7 squared. Because those create a square, and the units inside make perfect squares. So we need to make sure we know all of these, all the numbers that are perfect squares between 0 and 400. So when we talk about squaring a number, what we're really saying is when you have this big number down here, we call that the base, and then you got this little guy up here, we call that the exponent. This is really saying 10 squared, which all it really means is how big a square could fit inside something that has 10 units long. So if you had a square that was 10 units, so let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, let's see, add one more. Okay, let's go this way. 1, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, so now this is 10 on each side. If you were to count that, that would be the same thing as going 10 times 10, which we would know is 100. So we know that 100 is a perfect square because we already found that one. We already found that 100 was a perfect square right there. Okay. All right, so again, like I said, we call this guy the exponent. And all that says is the exponent tells you how many of the number to multiply together. This means multiply two tens together. So you always look at your base. Our base is 10. And our exponent tells us how many. So since there's a 2, it means I'm multiplying two tens together. And we said that that was 100 already. So let's look at this. So we'll do a couple of these together, and then I want you to go ahead and try it yourself. So we have 5 to the 4th. So 5 is our base, 4 is our exponent. So all this really says is that I'm going to have 4 5s. Okay? We have 4 to the 2nd power, so 4 is our base, 2 is our exponent. So we're going to have 2 4s. Okay, this one, 6 is our base, 6 is our exponent, so we're going to have 6 6s. Alright, okay, I want you to go ahead and pause this and just write down the problem. You don't have to solve it. Write down what you think each one of these exponents is going to have when we multiply it out, what it really means. So go ahead and pause and then push play when you're ready. Alright, welcome back. Let's check out how you did. So 3 to the 3rd is going to give me 3 3s. 8 squared is going to give me 2 8s. 2 to the 8th power should give me 8 2s. 9 to the 5th will give me 5 9s. 7 to the 3rd, 3 7s. And 4 to the 7th will give me 7 4s. Alright, so hopefully you did good on that. Alright, this just says square roots. We're asking what a square root is. A square root is not just a square that's at the end of a flower. What a square root really is when you find how large the sides of a square must be given the number of squares in it. So first of all, if we look at this, we read this as the square root of 81. So when you see this symbol right here, this kind of funny looking division symbol with the little check at the end, that just means a square root symbol. So this means the square root of 81. So the 81 means how big the square is. So I have a square that has 81 units inside. This is our square root symbol, also known as a radical. And it means how big are the sides if my square has 81 little squares inside. Okay, so we would know that I need a square So basically, all you need to ask yourself is, what two numbers do I know that I can multiply together to get 81? I know if I go 1 times 1, I'm going to get 1. 2 times 2 is 4. 3 times 3, 9. 4 times 4, 16. 5 times 5, 25. All right, and so on. And eventually, you would get 9 times 9 is 81. Okay, so that means we have a side that's 9 and a side that's 9. Because when I multiply those together, I get 81. Because 9 squared equals 81. All right, if I was to read this, we know that this means the square root. Okay, because remember, that's what that little check division sign means. Square root. And whatever number is inside, so we're seeing the square root of 100. So all this means is I have a square with 100 little squares inside, and we need to know what number I can multiply together to get that. So we should know that 10 squared equals 100, so that means each side is 10. So the square root of 100 is 10. Alright now, so think about this. We have the square root of a number has only positive answers, only negative answers, or both. Alright, so our answer to that is going to be C. It can have both positive and negative. Because you should remember that you can go a positive times a positive equals a positive, and a negative times a negative equals a positive as well. So when we do square roots, we can have a positive root or a negative root. So if I look at this, when I say what two factors can multiply together to get this, all I'm saying is what same number can I multiply to get 1? So I know I can get 1 times 1. 4 would be 2 times 2. 9 would be 3 times 3. Okay, 16, 4 times 4. 25, 5 times 5. 36, 6 times 6. 49 is 7 times 7. 64, 8 times 8. 81, 9 times 9. 100, 10 times 10. 121, 11 times 11. 144, 12 times 12. Okay, so what we should recall is that all these numbers that are in black right here, those are all perfect squares. Now, if I was to take the square root of those, it would just be the number that's multiplied together. So the square root of 1 would be 1. Square root of 4 would be 2. Square root of 9, 3. Square root of 16, 4. Square root of 25, 5. Square root of 36, 6. Okay, and so on. So if I look at this, if we ever have symbols that you see a square root, and x is going to represent a number, so an x is our variable. Remember, a variable is anything, is a letter symbol that represents an unknown number. So this can be any number inside. If you see just a regular square root sign, this just says the square root of x. And if there's nothing in front, we should know that that means it's a positive. And so this is asking for all the positive factors that are multiplied together to get the x. So if this said the square root of 9, my answer would be 3, because 3 is my positive factor that I can multiply to get a 9. Now if you see this negative sign out in front, that's asking you for all the negative square root of x. So it's asking you for the negative factors. So if I had negative square root of 9, that answer would be negative 3, because negative times a negative is the 9. So that's what that's asking you. All right, now, sometimes you need to find the square root of a number that's not a perfect square. We can do this, but it's sometimes difficult without a calculator, but we can always guess, and we can do that by finding the two whole numbers that it lies between. So if you look at the square root of 51, we know that 51 isn't a perfect square, because our first perfect square is 1, 4, 9, 16, 25, 36, 49, 64, 81, and 100. Those are my first ones up to 10. So this is for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. So if I look at this, I know that the square root of 1, of 51, lies between the perfect squares of 49 and 64. Okay, so let's erase this so we can see. So in that list I just wrote out, again, 1, 4, 9, 16, 25, 36, 49, 64, 81, and 100. So those are my between 1 and 10. All right, so I'm going to look at this, and I'm going to find what two perfect squares 51 is between. So 51 is bigger than 49, but smaller than 64, so I know that it lies between these two, because 51 is between 49 and 64. So therefore, since the square root of 49 is 7, and the square root of 64 is 8, the square root of 51 has to be between 7 and 8. And if I was to actually find that, the actual answer is 7.14. Okay, so between 7 and 8. Alright, so let's take a look at this. So we're going to just find the two consecutive whole numbers these square roots lie between. So it's easiest if we write down all of our perfect squares. So 1 has 1, 2 is 4, 3 is 9, 4, 16, 5, 25, 6, 36, 7, 49, 8 is 64, 9, 81, 10, 100, 11, 121, 12, 144, 13, 169, 14, 196, 15, 225, 16 is 256, 17, 289, 18, 324, 19 is 361, and 20 is 400. So this will help us figure out what these are between. So what you're going to look at is you have square root of 95. So what I need to do is go down my list and find which two numbers 95 is between. Well, I know 95 is between 81 and 100, so it's between 81 and 100, and so the square roots of those are 9 and 10. So I know 95 is between 9 and 10. All right, we got square root of 385. So if I go down my list, 385. All right, it's bigger than 361, but smaller than 400. So 361 and 400, so I know that this is between 19 and 20. All right, square root of 30. So go down right here, 25 and 36. So I know that's between 5 and 6. 256, okay, right here. That landed exactly on it, so we know that that's got to be just 16. All right, so you got 4 left, so go ahead and pause it, and then push play when you have your answers, and let's check and see if you're right. All right, welcome back. 154 is between 149 and 164. I'm sorry, 144 and 164. Sorry, 169. So we know that's between 12 and 13. All right, my next one, 138, that is between 121 and 144, so that's between 11 and 12. All right, 322, that's between 289 and 324, so that's between 18 and 19. And 75, that's between 64 and 81, so I know that that's between 8 and 9. Alright, so that was squares and square roots. As always, if you have any questions, come on in and ask.